So here's how badly CNN sucked in this Democratic debate the other night. There were two questions on the issue of impeachment. Now, those were the first questions, impeachment. It's fair to say, hey, man, it is a big issue, the impeachment inquiry. You know, they got to talk about that. What are they going to not talk about that? Fair enough. But it was two questions, and there was a lot of a giant chunk of time that was spent on it, which I think was too much. Two questions on impeachment, two questions on Russia and Putin. Two. And there were zero questions on climate change and zero questions on corruption. This is how bad CNN is. Now, the other thing is, it was all the questions that you could have guessed they would have asked up front. On the issue of healthcare, you want to take a guess? Go ahead. I'll give you 10 seconds here. What question do you think they asked on healthcare, specifically on the issue of Medicare for All? Okay, I lied. I'm not going to give you 10 seconds. I think I gave you like 4 seconds and that's good enough. How are you going to pay for it? How are you going to pay for it? The question is asked at every single debate. Every one. And I've not once seen a question at the debate where you ask the candidates who don't support Medicare for All, hey, how are you going to cover, how are you going to save the lives of the 30 to 45,000 Americans that die every year because they don't have basic health care? There's no way to save all of their lives without Medicare for All. Public option doesn't get us there. How are you going to save their lives? How are you going to stop the bankruptcy of 500,000 Americans that happens every year as a result of medical bills? How are you going to do that? You can't do that without Medicare for All. How are you going to do that? How are you going to cut the amount of money that we spend on healthcare in half? How are you going to do that and cover everybody? These questions are never asked. They never ask difficult questions to the people who don't support Medicare for All. And they're the ones that have the empirically, objectively worst position when you look at health outcomes, because we have all the evidence in the world when it comes to what will happen under these various systems. They never get asked questions. The only question that gets repeatedly asked is, how are you going to pay for it if you support Medicare for All? Guys, I don't know how many times I could say this. You know, I swear to God, I'm going to be 82 years old doing a show and saying the same thing. It saves money. Medicare for All saves money. The most recent research on this is from University of Massachusetts Amherst, and they found that Medicare for All saves $5 trillion over a 10-year period. $5 trillion. The old research that we were citing was from the Mercatus Institute, which is from the Libertarian Koch brothers, which was biased against Medicare for All. Even in that study, they found it saves $2 trillion. The study that I think is more objective, that makes more sense to me, says it saves $5 trillion. But bottom line is, the discussion is, how many trillions of dollars does it save? Medicare for All saves money. The other question, of course, they asked is, will it raise tax on the middle class? And there's this great tweet from Andy Richter yesterday where he was basically giving, like, the back and forth that always happens on this question is, are you going to raise tax on the middle class? Well, costs for the middle class overall will go down, but yes, we'll raise tax on the middle class. Next question. Okay, but are you going to raise tax on the middle class? Yes, but they'll save money. Okay, next question. Are you going to raise tax on the middle class? And it's just, it never ends. It doesn't matter how clearly you say, I will save money to your average American. Your average working American will save money. They will pay less for healthcare, but yes, the public taxes will go up. We'll be eliminating the private taxes. Okay, but will the taxes go up? Because listen, guys, and here's the point. It's not a good faith debate. It's not like, oh, let's actually have a battle of ideas and policies. No, it's, we're trying to play gotcha. We are corporate media. We don't like you lefties. So we're going to play gotcha, and we're going to try to portray you as the bad candidates who don't have their ducks in a row, when of course it's the opposite. All the centrist corporate goons don't have their ducks in a row. So, honestly, CNN did probably the worst job of any of the debates, and I'm not sure any of the debates have been good. It's so weird, because when you see a lot of the debates these days, like, Fox News manages to ask more reasonable questions than CNN. And I don't know, is it because Fox News already has that label of being, like, massively conservative, so they have leeway to not suck in some ways? Because it's like, well, we're already labeled as that anyway, so might as well, you know, maybe deviate from that norm. I don't know what it is, But in the case of CNN, you get the sense that there's all the time the right accuses them of being, you know, you're biased in favor of the left, left-wing media, liberal media, whatever the hell they say. And it's like, they're so scared of being labeled that, that they're like, oh, no, we'll ask really shitty questions the entire debate. Watch. And that's what they do. They ask really terrible questions. So, you know, honestly, the biggest loser of the night is CNN. You had Mayor Pete was terrible. Amy Klobuchar was terrible in terms of the candidates. Also, Kamala was bad. A lot of them were bad, man. They really were. So many of them were bad. But CNN was the worst of the worst. It's really hard to wrap your mind around the fact that there were two questions on Russia and Putin, two questions on impeachment, none on climate change, none on corruption. And by the way, when they spoke about foreign policy, you want to take a guess how the questions were framed? From a pro-war perspective. The questions were, of course, like, oh my God, can you believe we're pulling out of Syria? How terrible is that? What about the Kurds? Like, and don't get me wrong, are there legit concerns there? Yes, yes, but they never ask a serious question from an anti-war perspective. They never ask a question like, okay, we're in Syria illegally in the first place, under U.S. law and international law. If you want to stay in Syria, under what legal authority would you do so? They never ask that, ever, ever, ever. Would they ever ask a question about, you know, the U.S. and Saudi Arabia have armed some very sketchy moderate rebel groups that actually turned out to be jihadists. Would you stop this policy once and for all? Never! There's so many good questions you can ask from an anti-war perspective that never asked, ever, not once, ever. Cost! We were just talking about Medicare for All. How are you gonna pay for it? 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 They do that all the time. On war, ever? No, not once. Never in my life have I seen it on war. How are you gonna pay for the Syria intervention? How are you gonna keep paying for the war in Iraq? How are you gonna pay for the war in Afghanistan? How are you gonna pay for it? What are you talking about? How are you gonna pay for it? We've got 900 military bases around the world, and our infrastructure is crumbling at home. How can you afford to be the world police and be the world's sole superpower in an empire? How can you afford that? CNN is terrible, and I'll say it again, there's a reason why the label fake news sticks. It's not just with President Numbnuts, who, yes, every time he screams fake news, it's just because he doesn't like any story that portrays him in a negative way. We got it. He's biased, he's an idiot, he's a fool, he's a clown. I got it. Everybody understands that. But there's a reason why fake news resonates beyond that little Trump circle. Because you guys are terrible at your job, man. I mean, it's not even close. Oh, you think, I'm wearing a suit and tie, therefore I'm a serious person. Here's a bunch of terrible questions. Just because you're wearing a suit and tie, just because you're part of this behemoth network, which has been around for a long time, called CNN, doesn't mean that you're good. And in fact, you're not good at your jobs, and that's crystal clear.